okay, I'm going to share something with you that may scare the crap out of you, but I'm going to tell you right now that this is not going to happen in your lifetime, but it is happening right now, and it's a major indication of what happens within our universe, our planet, and us as individuals. Are you ready for this? This is going to shock you, but as you know, if you come to my channel, it's all good. I want to talk to you about how you can shift your thinking into something super powerful. You ready? Let's go. Welcome to Landria Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through those fears and live an amazing life. I have the ring light on. Does it look weird? I don't know. Anyways, I usually use sunlight, but we have a rainy day in Georgia. I'm going to share something with you. Guess what? Did you know that our galaxy, in fact, all the other galaxies around us, are dimming? They're down 50%, and they're going to continue to dim. It keeps dropping and dimming. What does that mean? Fewer stars are being born and more are dying than are being born, which means the light of our galaxy is dimming. 50%, now here's the good part, over 2 billion years. But what does that tell us? Our galaxy's dying and all the ones around us. What's going on? Now, here's the other thing. This is all science right now, real stats. Galaxies are moving away from us faster than the speed of light. That means we're expanding. But these galaxies that we are monitoring, science is monitoring, is showing that they are not regenerating themselves. They're down, like less than 10% of the stars are regenerating. In other words, being replaced, or there are new ones being born. So therefore, in 2 billion years, 50% dimming. And they showed the brightness, and boom, how dim it was compared to 2 billion years ago. What does that tell us right now? One thing that human beings don't accept is change and evolution. We think things are supposed to be a certain way, and we don't handle change easily. We hang on to it, even if it's bad for us. We don't accept death. We don't accept change. We don't accept the fact that our own planet is going to change. If there was never emissions or anything polluting, it still would evolve and change. It would eventually die. It doesn't die, it just evolves again. Yet we are so like freaked out about this is dying and that is dying. Nothing dies. Now we get a choice within all of this of how we handle everything that is alive, which is nature, the planet, one another. All the space that you don't see is intelligent energy, always us. It's just us, our beliefs, our actions, everything we do is creating our reality and the effects on one another as seemingly individuals, including that tree and you. The whole illusion is what we do within all of this creation. Everything continues to evolve. When these galaxies blink out, and they will at some point, then what? Does it start all over again? Are we in the final stages of whether or not we pull through this as individual energy fields? Are we going to take our frequency up? And then when that happens, we will be light beings again, which we go back into light being form after we come out of these bodies anyways. But what frequency is that on? Then we live in a completely different existence altogether. This is a little mind-blowing stuff. The galaxy's dimming doesn't bother me one bit. We look at that as something bad. It's like, okay, something else is going to come from that. Something else is going to be created from that. Maybe that universes won't exist anymore. Something completely different will exist. Maybe they're done with the universes. Yeah, maybe all of that is like, okay, been there, done that, and then some planets are going to be destroyed because they just didn't make it, because the people didn't evolve, and then they have to go off into some completely different format. Some are going to be advanced. There's so many out there that are super advanced that live in peace. They're probably petrified because we are affecting this whole energy field that we put out, this collective that we are part of. The universe, you know, feels that. Just like we do with one another, the universe is this big compared to what the one is. This is small. We are a grain of sand. We are one family on some little speck floating out in space. We're evolving. What you do right now counts. Separation is an illusion. But if you believe it, it's going to be part of your world. You're going to create that world, and you will go into a cataclysmic event that you don't want to experience, trust me. But it exists somewhere in a probability, because you're going to create it yourself. It doesn't ever have to exist for anybody, by the way. We can actually stop going into that space altogether. That's a fact, because that is quantum physics. We only participate in that which we observe. In other words, that probability, which is a wave, turns into particle only when we observe it, focus on it, we create it, we participate in it, we become entangled. Nobody has all the answers. Nobody truly even knows what quantum physics means. I think there's still limitations they're putting on it that are ridiculous, because there are no limitations. No one has the answers to anything. We know nothing, but we know that we are, and everything else is a power. We know that the ultimate unconditional love exists, and I believe that that is the source of the power, and that everything else is an exploration of that. And you are part of that. You get to choose. You're looking around and thinking this is material, things end, the planet's gonna end, whatever. Yeah, all right. But it doesn't have to end in a cataclysmic, destructive way with us opposing one another. Get over opposition. There's no bad guy. There can't be. Because we cannot be powerless unless we're handing that power over. And you're not powerless. You control your own destiny. You control your own reality. You control your feelings, your thoughts, your beliefs. And through that, that changes for you. So if you believe something and there's some battle going on out there, that is the power of the quantum field. It exists for you. There's no battle going on. Not for me. You don't have to believe anything I say. This is my opinion. Yeah, I get downloads. What's that mean? Right? You don't have to believe it. Maybe you're meant to, you know, wallow in your ego and argue with people on spiritual channels and tell people they're going to go to you-know-what in a handbasket. That's up to you. But the galaxies are dimming. That means that we're not recreating ourselves in this form. That means we're moving on to something else. And whether it's another 2 billion years, 50% down, right? Another 2 billion years. The fact is, energy cannot be created nor destroyed. So that energy is going into another form of some kind. So will you. And you may come back here and participate in that dimming of the universe, or galaxies, I should say. But you don't want to come back here in that form where there's struggle again. If you come back here, you may participate in a golden era where you're not in transit. Right now we're in transition. You may move past that. You may come back here when the new earth is here and it's amazing, and you get to participate in being, you know, a physical being and experience what it's like to be human, but it's going to be completely amazing, loving, giving, awesome. It's up to you. So not to fear what's happening out there is not going to be in your lifetime unless you live to be 2 billion years old. But it is happening, and people aren't talking about this. They're not talking about the evolution of everything around us. Do you know what's at the center of every galaxy? That we know of, at least. a black hole. And so Stephen Hawking has shared information that that black hole is actually disappearing. What happens when that happens? What? Why are they there in the first place? What is a black hole? Why are they changing? Why are they disappearing? And what happens when they disappear? No one has those answers. It's amazing. It's fabulous. It's just expressions. Not to be named good nor bad. Can you end the conflict? There is no enemy, my friend. There isn't one. Not what's going on our planet right now. They're all just opportunities for us to resolve issues, find solutions, come together, deal with being human. Human comes with some real challenges, experiences, you know, loss, feelings, illness. What does us all feel like? It doesn't have to be negative. Some things can be celebrated. It's your own individual decision. Don't think you know what somebody else is thinking, by the way. Get out of your own ego to try and interpret somebody else's feelings and thoughts. You know nothing about that other person. That person who's striking out, you don't know what they come from. You don't know what pain they may be feeling. And if you know their story, you may feel completely different about them. So can you show compassion? You don't have to know their story. You just have to know there's another human being playing out a journey, an adventure, and that when we transition out of here, we're all light beings. We all look the same. So, what's happening to the galaxy? Interesting, isn't it? I'll let you ponder that. Now, speaking of things disappearing into the black hole, my subscribers, I have more subscribers coming on, but I'm losing subscribers, and people are saying they're not unsubscribing, that they just are getting unsubscribed by YouTube. So I don't know if they have a time limit, if you're not active or whatever, but please subscribe, check and make sure you're subscribed so we can get those numbers up, we can share the world and just empower people and let them decide what they want to do. But maybe we'll reach somebody who may stop and think, yeah, it doesn't feel good to oppose another or be separate. I want to live in a peaceful world and I'm okay with change. We'll just do whatever we need to with it in a positive way. All right, you guys, you know what this is. You see this popping out. That's my internet marketing. People are taking courses online to learn how to create online businesses. We got people doing some really awesome stuff there, an amazing community, step-by-step training. This is a free video series that's just information. It's pretty cool. Empower yourself. Down below, you guys can take my courses. The New Earth Masterclass, of course, is very popular. 3 hours, and then the New Earth Workshop. Whoa, I loaded this baby up. I spent extra 2 months working on it. I expected it to be something short, but it is loaded with practices, step-by-step practice. Somebody said, how do I do this? I said, okay, you know, you have to practice, but I'm gonna give you real practices every day to work on. We're going to discuss it, and then you have practices to shift into that frequency, to release limitations, release the blocks, open up the box of what I believe things are, you know, how things work, and me thinking it's bad, you know, and judgment, all those things we have to move past. You cannot go to that new earth because that doesn't exist there. It's a state of being. It's not a place. It's a state of being. And people are experiencing it right now. If you saw my video, there's a shift happening right now. I'm feeling it. A lot of people are feeling it. I feel like something's happened, and it's good. But not if you're not in it. If you're not in that room with those people drinking champagne at the in the penthouse, and you're down in the basement, you know, with the mold and the, you know, rats, then you'll never see it. You won't experience it. So this shift is happening. I felt a big shift happen, really positive. I'm seeing companies change what they're presenting to people. I'm seeing a focus on community. I'm seeing a focus on a lot of really positive things, especially about what we consume, what we're eating, what we're putting in our home. Hey, you know, Pottery Barn saying, oh, non-toxic, bedding and stuff. I'm like, how did we ever allow it to be toxic in the first place? We didn't even know what we were using. So pay attention. You know, I have a lifestyle channel. You can go over there. I'm going to start posting more videos so that you can get that information, start making better choices. We can't play stupid anymore, can we? You're whole and perfect, strong and powerful, loving, harmonious, and happy. Come on over to LandriaOnkka.com for my spiritual training, free stuff over there. LandriaOnkka.net is the business training. There's free stuff there too. Empower yourself, my friend, because you hold it. You are unlimited, amazing, beautiful, perfect. Don't ever question that. And by the way, you're never alone. Namaste.